As soon as I received an invitation to the mansion, I knew this would be a chance of a lifetime. Political gain? Perhaps. Making nice with guests is my forte. A senator's wife always knows what to say and when. The name's Mrs. Peacock. I was enjoying a glass of brandy in the study when I heard a loud clang. The noise was so loud, I thought my glasses would break. I noticed a sound coming from the kitchen. I hurried over there, and that's when I saw.
What a dreadful night. I'm just burning up.
Oh. Hello, officer. You didn't think that I was singling you over, did you? Oh, no, no, no. You see, I'm just trying to cool off. All this ruckus has me on fire.
It could be the brandy.
It could be menopause. Either way, I feel faint. I feel as though I could pass out any second now. Any second. Questions for me? Whatever for? You don't think that I, a suspect? How absurd. Well, I suppose I can amuse you. Maybe that's the time. Let's see. It's all quite a fog, really. Are you writing all this down? You are. Okay, then. I'll try to get it right. I arrived at the mansion at 5:15 p.m. Yes, 5:15. I must admit, I'm quite the early bird. Yes, but to my surprise, I wasn't the first one there. No, Mr. Green and Miss Scarlet were there before me. They were in front of the mansion. Yes, just awkwardly staring at each other. Quite a lengthy staring match. Very odd, those two. Very odd. Let me take off my glasses. Yes, so I approached them and I stood with them quietly, very quietly, waiting for the other guests to arrive. And at about 6:30 p.m. we headed to the dining room. Yes, all six of us. And we sat down. And, well, while everyone was contemplating whether or not they were going to touch their plate, I decided to break the ice. You see, there is nothing for worse than silence. Yes. The second worst thing. We are in quite a rare predicament. So, as I was saying, I decided to get the ball rolling, you see. And I conversated with all of the guests. Yes, I do make quite an amazing hostess, if I do say so myself. Do you know my husband? I'm sure. Yes, he is the senator. What was that? You don't care for politics. What are you? Some sort of beatnik? Listen, officer. I don't know why you're all invited here. And I don't know what this place is all about. What I do know is that I want this nightmare. All of these questions to be over, too. Yes. Yes, yes. That is correct. Mr. Body did give us a gift to all six of us. To be honest, I didn't really get a good feeling about Mr. Body and that sinister smile. Remember what he gifted to me, to be quite honest. Trauma, it does crazy things, you know. Empty my bag. Whatever for. Well, no. So, you see, this may seem a bit out of sorts, but we were all running about from one room to the other. I noticed with all the commotion, some of the house guests had dropped some of their things. I was simply doing them a favor by collecting them and having them safe and sound in my bag until things calmed down, and I was able to, of course, give them back. A politician wife never bribes, I mean, lies. As I stated, my life is an open book, and these are the contents in my bag. Ah, yes, well, this is Miss White's hat. She dropped it in the conservatory. Now, I don't know if she did this purposely, or she simply forgot it. However, I grabbed it for her. It is a rather interesting hat, and I will say that she does look better without a hat. I do love her daring cut. And this, yes. So, Professor Plum dropped this in the library. I don't know what this is, to be honest. It's probably one of her many inventions. She's quite brilliant. Looks like a mini rake. Yes. Maybe a back scratcher. Anywho, I will be giving that back to her. Oh, this. This is... Well, I don't know what this is either, but... This is what it looks like. Very sticky. Colonel must have dropped this in study. It's some sort of weird matter. Quite messy, as you can clearly see. Which is why I kept it contained in that box. Do you want to hold it? No. Not the adventures that I see. Okay, well. Yes, this could take ages, couldn't it? Let's put this back. This? Yes, Mr. Green dropped this in the billiard room. Maybe it's some sort of holy water. Not quite. And this? Oh, this is mine. Yes, this is mine. My beautiful ruby ring. I've had this for years. It's a family heirloom. Yes, yes, yes. Let me just put this on. It's, kind of perfectly. Well, to be honest, the monkey brain soup must have done a number. You know, all that sodium. Anyways, let me take this off. And lastly, this. Yes, well, this is my nail filer. Yes, 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 yes. Just a new finding a way. How do you think I keep my nails so pointy, so sharp? Yes, yes. No, no, no. A dagger, no. You are a strange one, officer. You are indeed. Anywho, let's put this all back and move along, right? Nothing to see here. No, 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 no. How about I pour you a drink of good old bourbon whiskey? And we'll just forget about this, yes. Sounds good. I thought so. I thought so. Yes, okay. The liquor is kind of scarce here, so drink up, drink up, drink up. They're not the only ones who lost something. I lost my earring. Yes, diamond and sapphire. Irreplaceable. You know, I'm the victim here. Yes, me. I'm the victim. Well, I found Mr. Body. Yes, it was around 8:10 p.m. There was a ring at the door, and it was a man. Car trouble, yes. I think it was his tires. Anywho, I decided to go ahead and powder my nose. So, as I headed to the hall, There he was. Same sinister smile, but lifeless. Yes. And, well, I screamed very, very loud. I didn't think I could scream that loud. Like I said, all this is quite tragic. Mr. Barty, the motorist, the cook, and the girl. The girl. Me, who you should be talking to. In fact, you should be talking to Miss Scarlet. Truth be told, she had a thing with Mr. Barty. Yes, they knew each other quite well. Fiance, perhaps. I caught Mr. Barty and Miss Scarlet in the ballroom. They were having quite a heated argument. She was visibly distressed. I tried to go unseen, however. Miss Scarlet saw me, and she stormed out of the ballroom rather quickly. She dropped a letter, though, and I picked it up, glanced at it very quickly because Mr. Barty snatched it away from me. To Mr. Barty from Miss Scarlet. The suspicious part was that the handwriting was rather similar to my invitation. Yes. Now, I do believe Miss Scarlet is at the ballroom. Pleasure.